Welcome back to our lecture series in DC machines and transformer. So in today's class, we are going to discuss in detail about armature windings. So all of you know that in DC generators or DC motor, which is rotor and which is stator. The armature winding is placed in rotor and the stator is magnetic system. Okay, so briefly we can draw it like, suppose it is a four pole system. Previously you was discussing about a two pole system. Now I am drawing a four pole system: north, south, north, south. This will be the way of marking poles. Adjacent poles will be always having opposite polarity. Okay, so north, south, north, south. In such a system, we know that the armature windings are placed on the rotor, which is the rotating part of the machine. All the armature windings are placed on the rotor. So for that, rotor is a thing like a water bottle that we already done. Rotor will be like a substance like this. Its front view will be a circle that I am showing here, but in the side view it will have the entire conductor. Okay, so I hope you can view this green line. This is one conductor. This is A, B. So this is conductor A, B. Conductor A, B is the here. Now in the front view it will be a single point. I will draw it here, A, B. Correspondingly, this is one conductor. A single conductor cannot contribute a coil. For a coil, there is two conductor. This is a coil. This is starting end, this is finishing end. And we are naming it as A, B, C, D. So this is the coil. So actually now I am placed one conductor here, A, B. So where I have to place the CD? Where I have to place the CD? You have to think. Generally we know that in the last class, as there was two poles, we were placing one AB here, whereas CD is placed after 180 degree. This was AB, this was CD. So for a two pole system this is okay, but for a four pole system, how you can place this conductor CD? Where you have to place? What is the distance? Is it always 180 degree? No, it is not always 180 degree. So for that, first of all, the first term I want to teach you is pole pitch. Pole pitch. So from the name itself, it is very clear that it is something related to pole, and pitch is normally a word that represents distance. So it is something that relates distance of poles. Okay, so let me define pole pitch. Pole pitch is, you have to write it, pole pitch is distance between similar points of adjacent poles. I will repeat, pole pitch is distance between similar points of adjacent poles. Suppose this is a north pole, this point is you are considering as first point. Then which is the similar point in its adjacent pole? We can, by the naked eye itself, we can observe this is the south and the similar point is this. So pole pitch is distance between similar points of adjacent pole. So this is one adjacent similar point, this is one similar point. So that distance is one pole pitch. This distance is one pole pitch, PP, one pole pitch. Okay, can you mark another similar set of similar points? Another set of similar points? Yeah, this is one similar point. Which is the similar point in the next pole? This is the similar point in the other pole, because this is, as we are rotating from this direction, this is leading end and this is trailing end. Again, this is leading end, this is trailing end, like that. So these are the two similar points. Again, the distance is same, 180 degree in this case. Suppose this is one similar point. What is the adjacent similar point in the adjacent pole? This will be the adjacent point. Again, the distance, if you measure, it is 180 degree. So can you say a generalized calculation method? Is it is always 180 degree? No. In this case, we can say pole pitch is total mechanical degree 360 degree divided by 2, because 180 in this case. Now come to this case. Here, this is one south pole. Its adjacent pole is this north pole. So if you are taking this one as its adjacent, its similar point, then what is the similar point in the adjacent pole? This is the similar point. Now please measure the distance in angular degree. It is how much degree? It is 90 degree. So in this case, the pole pitch is 90 degree. Pole pitch is 90 degree. So can you find an expression like that? Pole pitch is equal to 360 by 4. That will give you 90. Here it is 2, here it is 4. Now tell me, what is the generalized expression for pole pitch? What is the generalized expression for pole pitch? It is 360 divided by number of poles. Number of poles. Pole pitch is 360 divided by number of poles. So first armature winding terminology is pole pitch. And what is pole pitch? Pole pitch is the distance between similar point of adjacent poles. And we can write pole pitch is equal to 360 by number of poles in degree. Okay. You can also express pole pitch in terms of slots also. That we will explain. Okay. So from the explanation that we have already done, you know that if ABCD is one coil, if AB is placed at center point under one north pole like this, here I am placing AB, I have to look this point of the pole. And if it is a two pole system, the CD will be placed, if it is a two pole system, the CD will be placed by checking the pole pitch. In this case, pole pitch is 180 degree, because adjacent point of this north pole and the same adjacent point under the similar next adjacent the similar point of adjacent pole, this midpoint are 180 degree apart. So we know that CD should be placed 180 degree apart. So pole pitch is the measure to determine where we have to place the finishing end. I will mark other combinations also. If we are placing AB here, then you have to place CD here, because this is one similar point under the next south pole. This is the similar point, and the distance is again, this distance is again 180 degree. But if it is a four pole system, you know that pole pitch is 90 degree. If it is a four pole system, pole pitch is 90 degree. So that you have to place like this, north, south, north, south. And if it is your rotor, if I am placing AB here, CD should be placed here. 90 degree is the difference. Now let me explain another concept. If it is a 12 slot machine, if it is a 12 slot machine with four poles, can you do the same thing? You have to practice north, south, four pole, north, south. But the difference is that now you have to think about the number of slots. How many slots are there? 12 slots are there. So I am dividing like this. Each division is one pole pitch, because pole pitch is 360 by number of poles, that is 360 by 4, that is 90 degree. Similarly, how many slots will be there under each pole? How many slots will be there under each pole? Slots per pole, that is equal to total, we are having 12 slots and we are having 4 poles. We will get 3 slots. So these 3 slots should come under this 90 degree. Let us check. 1, 2, 3. Under one pole pitch. Again, 1, 2, 3. Again, 1, 2, 3. Here also, 1, 2, 3. So we created 12 slots. Now you can think in some other way that what is pole pitch? Distance between similar points of adjacent poles. That distance is 90 degree. From this degree calculation, it is very simple, 360 by 490. In term of slots also, you can express this. 90 degree is nothing but spanned by 3 slots. So you can also define pole pitch as number of slots spanned by each pole. Please write that. Pole pitch is another definition. Pole pitch is number of slots, spanned by each pole, so that I am making a small change, that is nothing but this is also pole pitch. Pole pitch is equal to number of slots spanned by each pole. That is nothing but, for calculating that, total slots by number of pole, 12 by 4, 3 slots. So this is the point I want to convey, that if I am if I am placing one conductor AB here, where should I place the CD? The similar point, we can see that it will be this one. That is second slot of north pole to second slot of south pole. Distance between similar slot of adjacent poles. Previously it was distance between similar point of adjacent pole. Now I am converting that point to the slot. Everything is same. Distance between similar slots of adjacent poles. Again, in terms of degree, if your figure is exact, my figure is not exact, it's rough hand figure. In terms of degree, if you are using a set square, you will get the degree will be 90 degree. And if you are measuring the slots, you should get 3 slots. How you will get 3 slots? How you will get 3 slots? This is one slot, this is second slot. It is 2. No, no, it is not 2. You have to measure the slots where the coil is placed also. You have to measure this as half and this as half, because you are already occupying the slots. Then you will get 3 slots. Coil span is nothing but 1, 2, 2 and a half and 3. 3 slots. So this is the concept. So let me ask one question. If this is first slot, this is second slot, this is third slot, this is fourth slot, fifth slot, sixth slot, like that. So I have simply redrawn our figure. So you have to understand that if this is the center point, this is also the center point. Due to my mistake of my drawing, you may feel this is not symmetrical. This is exactly symmetrical. You have to draw like that. Okay. So let me ask some questions. Before that, I have numbered all the slots. This is a 12 slot 4 pole system. So that we know pole pitch is nothing but 12, number of slots by number of pole, that is 3, or in terms of degree, 3 slots. In terms of degree, we can pole pitch is equal to 360 by number of poles, that is 90 degree. Both are same, two statements. Now let me ask some simple questions. Okay. If I am placing one coil AB here in first slot, AB here means in front view you will see a single point, but in the side view it will be a full coil, full conductor AB, like this in side view AB, but in front view we are seeing it only as a single point AB. That is the concept. So where you have to place the CD? If I am placing it here, two method, you have to measure the degree, or simply you know it is 3 slots. So 3 slots means 1, 2. This is an half, this is also another half. So you have to place here. That is 1. It is the number of your finishing end slot. First slot, finishing coil is placed at, sorry, beginning coil AB is placed at first slot. AB is placed at first slot plus 3. That is nothing but pole pitch. That will give you 4. So you have to end at fourth slot. In other words, I will tell, if you are beginning from first slot of north, then you have to finish at first slot of south. If you are beginning from second slot of north, that is here. If you are beginning AB from here, second slot, slot number plus pole pitch 3, you will get 5. You have to finish at 5. 5 is nothing but second slot of south. So adjacent points. All coils are finishing in adjacent points. First slot of north to first slot of south. Second slot of north to second slot of south, like that. Here, I will tell you one important conclusion, that is about coil span. Coil span is nothing but number of slots or mechanical degree, because you are having two type definitions, in term of slot or in term of degree. Mechanical degree spanned by each coil. From this example of DC generator, I can say our coil span is nothing but that is equal to pole pitch. Let us check. If we are starting from 1 and ending at 4, what is the coil span? So for easy understanding, I will redraw the figure into a linear fashion. This is the actual view, but I will open it like this in a linear. I will start from this point and I will end up to this point. I will draw. This is a north pole. I will draw it like this, north, and then south, then north. Okay, like this. I will draw like this. Space issue. Okay, 4 poles. North, south, north, south. I will draw like this. In all the further classes, I will be drawing like this only. And we are having 3 slots. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Each pole is having 3 slots. That's why we are commenting pole pitch is 3 slots. Pole pitch is nothing but slots spanned by each pole. So 12 by 4, 3. Similarly, number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So, if I am placing my first coil on north, its finishing end should be placed at 4. And this distance is, if you are measuring by degree, it should be 90 degree, or if we are measuring by slots, it is 1, 2, and here 1 half is here, not like that, 1, half, half. So total slots spanned by the coil is 3 slots. So I can tell you one important conclusion. If you are winding like this, then coil span is automatically, coil span will become automatically equal to pole pitch. So what was the thing we have done in this class? Initially we started with pole pitch. We defined pole pitch, that is 360 by number of poles, or total number of slot by total number of pole. Then if I am ready to place my coil in such a way, then I have to call this winding in a specific name. That name is very important. I know what is coil span, but I know what is coil span and I know what is pole pitch. But here I am making these two equal. If I am placing my winding somewhere else like this, I am finishing here. Now please check, is it 90 degree? No, that will be definitely more than 90 degree. And its number of slots is, for the new setup, its number of slots is 1, 2, 3, and here half, here also half, that is 4. So coil span is 4, that is not equal to pole pitch. So that is also possible. You can wind your machine in such a way that coil span equal to pole pitch or coil span not equal to pole pitch. But in case of DC generator, important point, in DC generator or motor, coil span should be equal to pole pitch. And such a winding is known as, such a winding is known as full pitched winding. This is today's important conclusion. In DC generator and motor, we are using full pitched winding. In DC generators and motors, we are using full pitched winding. What is full pitched winding? Full pitched winding is a winding in which coil span is made equal to pole pitch. Coil span is made equal to pole pitch. Then you have to tell what is pole pitch. Pole pitch is always a constant number, like total number of slots by total number of poles. It is always constant for the particular machine. And in degree also we can express it. But it is your choice how you have to place your coil. If I am placing my coil like this, then it is matching. Coil span is equal to pole pitch 3. That winding is known as full pitch winding. Otherwise it is not full pitch winding. But in DC generator and DC motor, we are always using full pitched winding. So this is my first point. In armature winding, in DC generator and DC motor, we are using full pitched winding. And these full pitched winding are having further classification like lap winding and wave winding, single layer winding and double layer winding. Okay. So lap winding and wave winding, that is somewhat another area we will discuss in next class. Before that, what is single layer winding and what is double layer winding? I am going to that. Now I am explaining single layer winding and double layer winding. Single layer winding is only one conductor is placed inside a slot. Only one conductor will be placed inside one slot. That is the definition for single layer winding. In double layer winding, we may be generally having two conductors in each slot. Two conductors in each slot. In that one, if this is AB, first conductor of first coil, and if that is placed in top layer, its corresponding finishing conductor CD should be placed in bottom layer. That is, I will explain. If beginning end of one coil is placed in top layer, its corresponding finishing end should be placed in bottom layer of the corresponding slot. So if this is beginning end of another coil, its corresponding finishing end should be placed at top layer of the corresponding slot. That is another important point regarding two layer winding. In two layer winding, each slot carries two conductors. That is the definition of single layer winding and two layer winding. Okay, so in the next class we will be looking into lap winding and wave winding. So hope you enjoy this session. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.